My name is Alex Poli, otherwise known as Man One. I'm an LA-based artist. I was one of the first artists in LA, I think, to start working on a large scale as a professional graffiti artist.
So I want to say about 8 months ago, Russ mentioned that he wanted to put some huge art at our facility. We kind of just mentioned it. Not that I didn't take it serious, but I was like, okay, well. And then about 4 months ago, he just texted me and said, find some artists.
And Augie introduced me to Alex. Immediately upon meeting Alex, we hit it off. I met him and his son. How do I make this data center demonstrate the awesome power of what a cable can do? I think there's no more awesome power in the ocean than Poseidon.
Russ had this very specific Poseidon in mind that was from what he thought was from Clash of the Titans, the old movie. But I think it ended up being from Jason and the Argonauts. But it's a scene where Poseidon's coming out of the ocean and letting the ship through. I really like the fact that the background is going to be very different than the image. The background is a lot softer, there's a lot of brush strokes. I wanted to capture that kind of energy of like the rough seas and stuff like that. And the Poseidon, you know, is going to be a lot more cut and linear. I must have a couple thousand cans, and I go through them pretty quickly, so I'm always restocking.
Yeah, I got different brands that I use, so. Some brands have better colors in the reds or others in the blues, etc. So, kind of a little bit of everything. Let's see, I'm missing.
Once I pick one color, then it just naturally leads me to the next color and the next one. And a lot of it is very much intuitive, and I don't think about it too much.
Sometimes I only use a little bit, but I need that little hit of color. To me, this is the fun part. This is the part that's gonna make it or break it.
Don't sweat the technique. Let's trace the hits and check the file. Let's see who bit the dot, check the style. I flip the script so it can't get filed. At least not now, it'll take a while. I change the pace to complete the beat. I drop the bass to MCs get weak. For every word they trace is a scar they keep. Cause when I speak, they freak to sweat the technique.
Production of the mural was interesting because the mural itself is 17 feet tall by 20 feet wide, and my studio walls are only 12 feet high. So what we decided to do was break down the mural into 8 different panels. My son Alex, he's been helping me in the studio. He was really freaked out at the size of this project. So at any given moment, I only had half the mural up.
Push it against the wall. Push it against the wall. Push the cup against the wall. Don't pull it back. Push it forward. I'm holding it. I got the weight. I just gotta.
Started kind of from the top of the image and worked my way down, and had to shuffle the panels every time we'd finish a section. So I actually didn't even see the final result, the final full mural, until we installed it. It's fun to have my son by my side helping me make this happen. I had first the background painted out, then I had the image sketched on top of it with a projector onto the panels themselves, so I can get an accurate sketch to scale. But that's kind of what you have to do to get the correct proportions on something that's so large, especially when you don't even have the opportunity to stand back and see the full thing. So I kind of went back and forth from sketching with using the projector and just kind of freestyling it. There was no school for graffiti, and you can't really learn it except on the streets. So that's kind of like the schooling I took as a young kid. I went on to get my degree in fine art at Loyola Marymount University and get that actual, you know, academic part. But what I really love is large scale painting, you know, i.e. murals. So when Russ approached me about doing this project, and it was really intriguing and interesting for me to figure out a way to convey his message of what he, you know, wants to convey, which is in an industry that I've never even heard of. I had no idea that there was even such a thing as undersea cables, you know? It's really interesting to be doing a project having to deal with something that's technology, that's about communication and about, you know, connecting people, like literally connecting people. Yeah, you know? We finished everything.